Section 4.2, Least Squares Regression. We will look at these three objectives in this section. First, let's look at an example. We want to find an equation that describes our linearly related data. Using the following sample data, the first thing we want to do is find our linear equation that relates x and y. By selecting two points and finding the equation of the line containing the points. We will use the points 2 and 5.7 and 6 and 1.9. We'll call this one x1 and y1, and this one x2 and y2. Remember from algebra, to find our slope, we take y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So we have 1.9 minus 5.7 divided by 6 minus 2. So we have negative 3.8 divided by 4, which will give us negative 0.95. Now we use the point slope equation of a line to find our line. Remember that that is y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So we have y minus 5.7 equals m, which we found to be negative 0.95, times x minus x1, which was 2. We'll distribute our negative 0.95 to both values. We have y minus 5.7 equals negative 0.95x plus 1.9. Now we'll add our 5.7 to both sides. And this is a constant, so we add it to the constant and not the variable. We end up with y equaling negative 0.95x plus 7.6. And this then is our equation of our line. Here you'll see we've graphed the equation of the line on our scatter diagram, where we plotted all of the individual data points. Now let's use the equation to predict y if x equals 3. Remember that our equation was y equals negative 0.95x plus 7.6. So we'll simply plug in the value of 3 where x is. And we'll now evaluate our equation with that number in for x. And we see when we do this that we'll get the value of 4.75. For objective 1, we want to find the least squares regression line and use the line to make predictions. The difference between the observed value of y and the predicted value of y is the error, or the residual. Using the line from the last example and the predicted value at x equals 3, and here we see our data from our prior example. Remember, the residual is going to be equal to the observed value for y, the one from the table here, minus the predicted value for y. So our residual will be equal to 5.2 minus the value we got from our equation we used, which was 4.75. And we see that we get a residual of 0.45. And here we see a good visual of this. You'll see that we've taken the point on the line at 3, which is what we got from our equation, and the actual data point from the table, which is slightly above it, the little dot above. And we see that that is then the residual, the distance between the two. The residual will always go vertically up and down and not side to side or horizontally. The least squares regression line is the line that minimizes the sum of the squared errors or residuals. This line minimizes the sum of the squared vertical distance between the observed values of y and those predicted by the line y hat. We represent this as the following. The equation of the least squares regression line is given by the following. Y hat is equal to b1x plus B0, where B1 is equal to R, which is our correlation coefficient, times the standard deviation of the y variable divided by the standard deviation of the x. This is the slope of the least squares regression line. And B0 is equal to y bar minus B1 times x bar. And this is the y-intercept of the least squares regression line. Note that x bar is the sample mean for x, and s sub x is the sample standard deviation of the explanatory variable x. Y bar is the sample mean for y, and s sub y is the sample standard deviation of the response variable y. So let's recall our example about drilling, which we used in the first section for this module. We want to find the least squares regression line first. Then we want to predict the drilling time if drilling starts at 130 feet. Next, we'll ask the question, is the observed drilling time at 130 feet above or below average? And then lastly, we want to draw the least squares regression line on the scatter diagram of the data. So first, we're going to find the least squares regression line. We can do this by hand using our formula we were given, or we can use technology. In the same way that we found our linear correlation coefficient in the previous section, we can also find the regression equation. Remember that the diagnostic must be turned on. We press STAT and hit Enter to verify that our data is in List 1 and List 2. Then we press STAT again, go to Calc, and use number 4 and hit Enter. And we see that our equation is y equals ax plus b, and a and b are the first two values given. So our regression equation is this. Next, we want to predict the drilling time if the drilling starts at 130 feet. So we take our regression equation and we plug in 130 in for our variable x, and we evaluate. And we see that we get the value of 7.035. Now we want to look at whether or not the observed drilling time at 130 feet is above or below the average. The observed drilling time is 6.93 seconds. The predicted drilling time we found was 7.035 seconds. So the drilling time of 6.93 seconds is below average. And here we see the least squares regression line drawn on top of the scatter diagram for the data. Objective 2, we want to interpret the slope and the y-intercept of the least squares regression line. The slope of the regression line is 0.0116. For each additional foot of depth we start drilling, the time to drill 5 feet increases by this amount in minutes on average. The y-intercept of the regression line is 5.5273. To interpret the y-intercept, we must first ask two questions. One, is 0 a reasonable value for the explanatory variable, or our x variable? Do any observations near x equals 0 exist in the data set? A value of 0 is reasonable for the drilling data. This indicates that drilling begins at the surface of the Earth. The smallest observation in the data set is x equal 35 feet, which is reasonably close to 0. So interpretation of the y-intercept is reasonable. The time to drill 5 feet when we begin drilling at the surface of Earth is 5.5273 minutes. But we must exercise caution. If the least squares regression line is used to make predictions based on values of the explanatory variable that are much larger or much smaller than the observed values, we say the researcher is working outside the scope of the model. Never use a least squares regression line to make predictions outside the scope of the model because we can't be sure the linear relation continues to exist. For objective 3, we want to compute the sum of squared residuals. to illustrate the fact that the sum of squared residuals for a least squares regression line is less than the sum of squared residuals for any other line, we're going to use the data from the first example. Notice that we've listed x and y in our chart here. From the line we found in the very first example, we can find the residual for each value, which we then square. Then we find the residual for each data point using our regression line. We then square those values as well. The sum of our residual from the first line is equal to 3.535. And the sum of our residual from our regression line is equal to 1.696. Notice that the sum of the squared residuals is smaller for the least squares line than for the line we came up with in the first example. And this will always be true.